Starkiller919 here. Today I'll be reviewing All Tomorrow's Parties, a song that I consider to be very surreal and very subversive, which I would consider to be one of my favorite songs off of the 1967 debut album from the infamous band Velvet Underground, from their debut album, The Velvet Underground and Nico, with also Andy Warhol. What the song offers to the table is for how ancient and authentic the song is. The pre-arranged piano backing is beautiful. It makes the song really surreal, and it takes the listener for a really lucid trip into the song. Nico's powerful voice gives the track a much greater impact on the lyrics. The lyrics of the song are based off of a nursery rhyme, Monday's Child, which goes like this. Monday's child is full of faith. Tuesday's child is full of grace. Wednesday's child is full of woe. Thursday's child has far to go. Friday's child is loving and giving. Saturday's child works hard for a living. And the child born on Sabbath day is Bonnie and Blythe, good and gay. The main purpose of the song is to teach children the days of the week and the concept of Christian religion. Essentially, it's just a pure and innocent rhyme to say that rhymes. Nico uses the Thursday child line and reinterprets and reinvents the line into a song about a girl contemplating of going to a party and the fears of her own appearance, as she does not, and she does not own any dresses. Rather, the dresses/robes she works in are either borrowed or hand-me-downs, and her own insecurities of the situation she is in causes her to break down and cry. And in a way, it's a song about growing up and feeling the pain inside of you, and of not having a greater social status, of just being someone who has to borrow robes and dresses just to look like as if you belong somewhere, in this case, a party. And then to only realize that all tomorrow's parties will never come. The song ends on a bittersweet note. A blackened shroud, a hand-me-down ground, of rags and silk, a costume fit for one who sits and cries for all tomorrow's parties. Yeah, I'm not the greatest singer at all. I don't sing for a living, but off tangent there. The song ends for what a Thursday's child represents. An individual who still has a long way to go for their own future, and for this girl's case, is essentially a party that will never come, hence the title, All Tomorrow's Parties. A lack of progression for this girl, and no literal result for this song. The whole tone of the song just fits. It feels like as if it would be fitting to be played at a ballroom party. And again, Nico's vocal harmonies just carries the song with those and along with the grandiose instrumental in the background. The song is truly one of my most favorite songs of all time. Like and subscribe. Next week, I'll be covering the song Two-Headed Boy by the infamous band Neutral Milk Hotel. Thank you, and have a good day. Bye!